renovation and restoration. And I feel, I've been talking to Shivendra, that my book is associated with that, that unless you preserve and unless you restore, then you're not able to otherwise document it and research it. Like I had so many hardships in collecting things from the past. And you are somebody who has always felt very passionately about this and spoken eloquently about this.
I just felt that in India we don't have the habit of any kind of documentation, and a lot of our valued heritage has been lost or is getting lost every day. I'm really thankful to Shivain for initiating the heritage concept. I was there for the inauguration when we introduced the institution that is now going to be looking after the heritage of films. And I have volunteered to work in this cause, and Shivain, anytime as always, when you shall need my services, I shall always be there. But really, it's wonderful to have Bhavna put all the thoughts together. The generations to come will want to know what happened in the early years. And there really is no reference point for it. And I think that for somebody like her to put across the 100 years of cinema in the form of a book, which is not like reading a book, it's more interesting to watch it, to go through it in a very fun way. And I think that's a very novel idea, to keep the audiences and the readers attracted to something like this. So I compliment you, Bhavna, for that. I also feel that in the years to come, both Shivain and you should join up and make many more such examples of our heritage. It was heartbreaking to see what we saw in the film, of how films are being destroyed. We used to joke during the time when we used to work with film, now of course we work with digital, that every time a take went wrong, we used to joke, chalo yaar, iski chudiyan to ban jayengi kam se kam. Whatever film used to be left over at that point of time, unki chudiyan banayi jati thi. Pata nahi abhi bhi banti hai ya nahi banti. But can you imagine the amount of valuable footage that has gone into that escapade? So thank you, Shivain. Thank you, Bhavna, for putting all this together. And anytime you need any further help to either propagate or to work towards its heritage, I shall always be there. Thank you.
Movie watching habits has got to do a lot with your childhood memories, how you were exposed to cinema. For example, we used to have holidays on Thursdays. And my mother used to say that if you finish your homework on time, then your father and I are going to take you for a movie. And my sister and I would finish our homework, we would pack our school bag, and we would be ready to go for a film. Most of the time, joined by my nephews and nieces, a car full of people. My mother would pack homemade snacks wrapped in her cloth bag, which was in the dark distributed to us children, because buying the popcorns was expensive for so many children. What are your memories of childhood? How were you exposed to films? How did you watch them? I have always been curious to know.
I was born and brought up in Allahabad in Uttar Pradesh. And in Allahabad, the Capital Cinema was the very prominent theater where we used to go and watch films. In our time, parents used to go and wet a film before the children were allowed to go and see it. So, jo bhi filmein aati thi aur jiske liye hum chahte the ki hamein jana hai use dekhne, pehle wo dekhte the, uska anuman lagate the ki ye dekhne layak hai ki nahi bachchon ke liye. Uske baad hamein ijazat milti thi wahan jane ke liye. Capital Theater shayad ab bhi hai Allahabad mein, aur uski uniqueness ye thi ki वो एक सिनेमा थिएटर था, लेकिन साथ में एक रेगुलर थिएटर भी था. उसके ऊपर स्टेज परफॉर्मेंसेस भी होती थी, ऐसा स्टेज बनाया हुआ था वहाँ. और कई बार वहाँ पर हमने पृथ्वीराज कपूर और उनकी जो पृथ्वी थिएटर्स ग्रुप था, उनका वहाँ पर हमने उनके प्लेस देखे. और लॉरेन एंड हार्डी की एक फिल्म थी द फ्लाइंग ड्यूसेस, वो मेरी पहली फिल्म थी. और उसके बाद जितनी भी ये सिंड्रेला और लिटिल रेड राइडिंग हुड, इस तरह की जो फिल्में आती थी डिज्नी की, वो देखने जाते थे। हिंदी फिल्म शायद जो पहली देखी थी वो शायद जागृति थी, बहुत ही पुरानी फिल्म थी, बच्चों के ऊपर एक फिल्म बनी थी। और कई सालों के बाद इलाहाबाद में पहला एयर कंडीशन थिएटर बना, उसका नाम था निरंजन, और हम लोग वहाँ देखने गए थे एक फिल्म जिसमें दिलीप साहब थे और देवानंद साहब।
It is very strange that you remember both the films, but of course you have a great memory. I have been trying to think which was the first film I saw, and I have still not been able to recall. I am looking always for images where I will catch the memory of that film, but it doesn't come back. But I have memories associated with every film I have watched. For example, I remember that Amar Akbar Anthony, I saw it with all my college friends who are sitting there. I remember I saw Deewar with my sister in Badal Bijli. And the lights had gone out, and they said we don't know when the lights will come back. This was happening in the climax scene when Nirupa Roy is, you are on her lap, and nobody moved, and we were all so patient and accustomed to the lights going out, waiting, enjoying the film, coming out. And how things have changed now. You go to the multiplexes, it's air conditioned, the popcorns are expensive, but nobody feels the pinch somehow. The spending habits have changed. कई बार रेडियो के इंटरव्यू के दौरान सिद्धार्थ मुझे पूछते हैं कि आपका सबसे फेवरेट दर्शक कौन सा है, विच इज़ द बेस्ट। मुझे सिनेमा का सबसे फेवरेट दर्शक कौन सा है, विच इज़ द डेकेड दैट आई वैल्यू द मोस्ट। माय फेवरेट डेकेड इज़ द 50s, बिकॉज इट अशर्ड न्यू वेव सिनेमा, ग्रेट फिल्म मेकर्स एंड ग्रेट म्यूजिक। And my second favorite is the 70s, because I was finding my roots in journalism at that time, and because I think the decade is very dramatic in writing, in performances. What are your favorite decades?
Jitne bhi decades hain sab mere favorites hain.
Sabse zyada ek to bata de.
Nahi, bada mushkil hai kehna. Aapne jaise kaha ki jo 50 का दशक था, उस समय तो हम लोग को इजाज़त मिल रही थी कि फिल्में जा कर के देखें, तो वो बहुत ही एक आश्चर्यजनक चीज़ होती थी। निरंजन सिनेमा जिसकी हमने अभी चर्चा की, वो इसलिए याद है और वो फिल्म इसलिए याद है क्योंकि एयर कंडीशन थिएटर जो था वो एक आविष्कार था, बहुत ही अद्भुत लगता था हमें यार, एक सिनेमा घर जो है वो एयर कंडीशन हो सकता है, तो वो याद हमारे साथ थी। और रुपये पैसों की बात की तो हम लोग तो वो सामने जो लकड़ी के बेंच होते थे उस पर बैठते थे, 8 आना टिकट होता था उसका, क्योंकि आज के ज़माने में 50 पैसे हैं, और ऐसे हम लोग फिल्में देखते थे। और हर दशक में हमें कुछ ना कुछ एक नया देखने को मिला, नए कलाकार देखने को मिले, नया संगीत, नए निर्माता निर्देशक। ये कहना कि ये दशक पहले दशक से ज़्यादा बेहतर था, ये कहीं ना कहीं अत्याचार होगा बहुत, क्योंकि ये हर दशक में कोई ना कोई एक हाँ कुछ नया लाया है, नए कलाकारों को पेश किया है। और आज भले ही हम बैठ करके यहाँ कह सकें कि जो 50 का दशक था, जो 60 का दशक था वो अच्छा था, लेकिन आज से 10-20 साल बाद लोग कहेंगे कि आज का दशक जो है बहुत सुंदर लगा।
आज का दशक तो बहुत स्पेशल है ही, बिकॉज बहुत बेहतरीन फिल्में बन रही है, रियलिस्टिक फिल्में बन रही है, बहुत रियलिस्टिक परफॉर्मेंसेस दिए जा रहे हैं। मिसाल के तौर पे सिर्फ आपकी फिल्म की भी बात करें तो पिकू का जो आपका कैरेक्टर है और जो सब्जेक्ट है, ये हम सोच भी नहीं सकते हैं कि सिर्फ कॉन्स्टिपेशन पर एक फिल्म बन सकती है। या पिंक में इट इज़ द फर्स्ट टाइम इन हिंदी सिनेमा द वर्ड वर्जिनिटी इज स्पोकन, a reference is being made to virginity. Otherwise, if a Hindi film heroine has to be completely pure, agree, Meeta?
Yeah, ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा कहते हैं उसके पाँव भारी हो गए। But yes, both Piku and Pink were in a way a great revelation. I felt Piku because it brought in a film which had really no story. Just a relationship between a daughter and a father, and there was a great amount of identification with the daughters of the world, and particularly in India, because many of the daughters who saw the film for the first time invited their parents and their fathers to come along to see it again because they identified with that relationship. Pink, of course, the issue was so strong and so valuable and so pertinent in today's times that it was something that needed to be said, and it had to be said in as powerful a manner as possible. I'm really very grateful to Shujit Sarkar and Anirudh and Ronnie Lahiri for making that film and even thinking about it. And thinking about it not so much in a way to preach the content, but I felt to just touch it very briefly and leave a lasting impression. Devising that last comment of the film, No Means No, was by itself very debatable when we were discussing the script. It was felt by the writers and the directors at that time that in the final summation of the court scene, I would get up and make a long speech which would encapsulate all that had happened in the film from the start to the end. But I felt that having said so much already, and all the lawyers that were arguing for and against had said so much that really wasn't needed. And because Deepak Sehgal, who is the character in the film, was hesitant in the beginning because of his bipolar condition to make any kind of argument in court, he would stand up and say, no questioning, Your Honor, or no, Your Honor. I felt if we played on the word no, it would just fall in line with the character. And then the writers and us thought that why can't he just work on the word no? And I thought that that was a brilliant piece of writing by Vitesh Shah when he discovered this sentence. And the way he put it that when a woman says no, you need to stop. And it can be anybody, your friend, your partner, your sex worker, even your own wife. And I thought that that was extremely powerful. And I'm so happy to have been associated with a film of this nature, because in many ways, it almost became revolutionary. The tagline became the tagline of the nation. And in some of our interviews that we did during the promotion of the film with the media, there were at least two instances where the lady interviewer actually broke down in tears while she was interviewing us. That's how it affected many people and many women. We still have a long way to go, and we hear of some incredibly hideous incidents that keep happening in our country. And I do pray and hope that they stop. And I do hope and pray that films like Pink will bring in some sense into these terrible incidents that keep happening.
It's been 47 years and you're still facing the arc lights. How are you feeling? What are the changes you see on the sets, off the sets, in the audience?
Yeah, a couple of technical things have changed. There's no longer film, so I don't know whether we should start referring to the industry as a film industry, because we're not using film anymore. It's all digital. That's the difference. With that difference, a lot of the making procedure has changed. For me as an artist, we were so conscious in our earlier years of not wasting film because it was the most expensive product in the costing of the film. And so every time we went up to give a shot, we were terribly, terribly conscious that we have to finish it in one take, or either we're going to get thrown out of the film, or we're never going to get another chance. So having lived with that kind of phenomena and the danger that you have to get it right the very first time was kind of limiting us in case we wanted to improve in the next day. We never got an opportunity. Many a times, for example, working with the Rishikesh Mukherjee, I used to tell them, Rishida, can I have another take? He said, no, ye ek take bahut acha hai. I said, please, dada, ek take aur de dijiye. Theek hai, take karo, iska paisa tum dena. तो these were some of the limitations that we lived with. But now it's digital. The camera doesn't stop, and the producer doesn't care if it doesn't stop because it's just limitless. And we use this to great effect in the film Pink, and I keep referring to that because the entire courtroom scene was shot with 7 digital cameras, and there were, you know, 20-30 pages of scenes that just went on endlessly without stopping or without cutting. But each camera was catching some character, some actor that was involved in the scene. So it's not like you went, said your lines, and then went back to your vanity van or your makeup room and didn't bother about what was happening next. You did your shot and you were still involved in the scene, because even when you were walking back to your chair in the set, you were being followed by the camera and your reactions were being noted. This was something very revealing. There was a lot of honesty in the way it happened. There was a lot of concentrated interest in what was going on. Normally what would happen that you would do a close-up and go away and not bother with what your colleague was going to do or how he was going to perform or enact that scene. If you had a double shot, yes, you are aware of it, but sometimes when they're doing a close-up, you're not there. But here we were in the world of digital cinema, absolutely involved in everybody, every person that was sitting in the scene, even though he wasn't saying anything. We would be having the liberty to notice him and prepare ourselves for what was going to come next as naturally as possible. So that was the technical difference. The other thing that we notice now is many women on set. In my time, there were just 2, the leading lady and her mother as a chaperone. But now you have almost 50% of the workforce, and that is really creditable, the workforce, all managed by young girls, whether it is in production, whether it is in the camera department, whether it is in the continuity department. They're just looking after everything, and it's just wonderful to see the kind of dedication and devotion that they put in. We rely a lot on them because for some reason we feel that the ladies are never going to make a mistake. And it works out really, yes. They're very efficient, and I really love the moment when I'm on set because I just feel free to be able to say my lines and be involved in the scene and not worry about what my continuity is or what I should be wearing or which button of my jacket was opened in the previous shot. These were things that we had to look after ourselves in my time. But now there are wonderful ladies that come around and do this for you. But really want to compliment that entire atmosphere. But look at not just the workforce, but look at the women writers and directors who have come forward and done so brilliantly well. In the last 2 or 3 years, 4 or 5 years, we've had some very prominent directors and we've had excellent writers. And I hope that this continues because really we need them to come forward and tell the men that they are better than them.
That is great insight into what was happening in cinema in the olden days and what is happening now on the sets. Mr. Bachchan just mentioned about watching a film on a bench and his ticket was 8 annas or something. I remember my mother when she was in Karachi, there used to be Janana shows, and I think they were carrying the children with them free and they would sit on a small bench and maybe it was 20 paise or something. So after so many years, when Bandit Queen was released, there was a ladies show for the first time. So it was something that happened after decades. In a recent interview, you said, "Hey, I don't know so much about cinema. My wife knows more than me." Today, discussing the digital observations about how the whole scenario has to be there and so many other new insights, I don't think that is true at all.
No, it is. I mean,
do you just survive for 47 years like that only?
No, somebody wrote things for me. Somebody asked me to wear something. Somebody told me, walk here, say these lines here. I just followed like a robot and I was lucky. But Jaya has a lot of insights into a film, into the story, into the making. I missed the point many times, and that's why I said what I said.
We are lucky to have Mr. Bachchan here share his observations on his own cinema and about the changing cinema, about the changing decades. I had promised him that I was going to set him free before 7:45, and I think I have kept my promise.
Thank you. While we were talking about cinema and stories and why this photograph was there on the front page, and my lack of knowledge about assessing what a story and a film is going to be like, when Manmohan Desai came to me and said, I'm going to make a story called Amar Akbar Anthony, I said, man, tu pagal ho gaya yaar. Kaun dekhne jayega aisi picture jiska naam hai Amar Akbar Anthony? In an era when films like Badi Behan, Choti Bahu, is tarah ki title ki film aaya karti thi, wahan par Amar Akbar Anthony, I said, pagal ho gaya, koi nahi dekhne jayega. He abused me and said, you watch what happens. And then, to our horror, we had the opening scene of the film where three brothers are lying in hospital and one tube is going from each one of their veins into one lady. I said, man, this is atrocious. This is not permissible in medical history. Forget cinema. He said, chup-chap baitha rahe tu, kuch mat bol, abhi dekhna kya hota hai. And, you know, when the film was released, when this shot appeared in the opening sequence, there was huge applause in the audience. So, obviously, my knowledge of cinema is useless, and Manmohan Desai was much better.
So tell us about this egg scene, because it's my book cover, so we would
like
to know
how it happened. This is one of the atrocities that he asked me to do. You know, tere ko ande ke andar se nikalne ka hai. Maine kaha, okay, yaar, abhi kya karein? Yeah, because the girl was Christian and it was Easter, and he made me wear something which was very Christian looking, and made me do all kinds of things and asked me to recite some lines. I used to just fool around with the English language,
yes.
The whole country of the system, because
yeah, there is a story,
it's a lot
about
of rubbish.
What you've
but
spoken,
you know,
right?
He heard me saying it someday and he said, hey, put this in the song. That was another moment of madness, but you know, that was what Manmohan Desai was. He was a genius, truly.
Javed Akhtar once said about Amitabh Bachchan that asal zindagi mein unki koi bhi ideology kyun na ho, unki jo bhi raaye ho, magar ek baar wo set par aate hain, aap unke haath mein talwar do, chaku do, gun do, sitar do, kuch bhi do, he will do it with conviction. And that is why he came out of an egg and he made us laugh and cry. Thank you, Mr. Bachchan.
Thank you.
Well, बहुत ही अच्छा लॉन्च था. भावना जी ने एक बहुत अच्छा एक तोहफा दिया है इस देश को इन द फॉर्म ऑफ 100 years of Indian cinema, once upon a time in India. बहुत अच्छा लगता है जब कोई इतनी मेहनत के साथ में इतना अच्छा कुछ पेश करें. एंड काफ़ी मेहनत की है उन्होंने इस बुक के ऊपर. अलग स्टाइल का है, बिल्कुल डायरी फॉर्म में है, उसमें स्पाइरल बाइंडिंग है, एक एकदम अलग स्टाइल से ये बुक जो है पब्लिश हुआ है. एंड ऑफ कोर्स अमित जी जो थे उन्होंने इसका लॉन्च किया है एंड ही वाज फैबुलस. उन्होंने बहुत मज़ेदार किस्से सुनाए हैं, सिनेमा तब सिनेमा अब, उसमें क्या फ़र्क था तब और अब में, एंड उनके पिक्चर के बारे में भी उन्होंने कई किस्से सुनाए हैं. तो इट वॉज़ वेरी एंटरटेनिंग, इट वॉज़ लवली. इंजॉय तो सबने बहुत किया. Well, you know, we've grown up in the same industry with my father and him and everybody. And I think Sholay was the first film I ever saw. And Hathi Mera Saathi. And, you know, so I've watched Sholay maybe about 30 times. You know, so it's an iconic movie for me. And of course, body of work, even recently, as they were mentioning Piku and Pink and all these amazing films. You know, he's given cinema such amazing memories. So, you know, part of the same fraternity, you know. There's his generation, my dad's generation, then his children's generation, my kids' generation. Now his granddaughter's coming to the picture, as is my daughter Alia. So they're also the same age. So it's really nice to see generations and generations come into the business, do their own thing, fly. It's really beautiful.
Thank you.
Sure.
हाँ जी.
ओके मैम, सबसे पहले तो
अभी हो गया है ना आपका?
ऑडियो में प्रॉब्लम आ गया तो मैं
अभी I'm not doing any more interviews. ये किताब है हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडियन सिनेमा की फ्रॉम 1913 टू 2013. बहुत इलेबरेटली या सीरियसली बात नहीं की है मैंने. बहुत रीडर फ्रेंडली की तरह इस किताब को पेश किया है और छोटे छोटे पैराग्राफ्स हैं हर साल के. और जिस तरह से इस किताब को पैकेज किया गया है तो वो यंग जनरेशन को एड्रेस करता है जिनको इसकी कहानी नहीं मालूम है. जैसे हमारे माँ और दादी नानी हमको पलंग पे बिठा के रात को कहानी सुनाते थे, तो इसमें से वो बेड टाइम स्टोरीज़ की तरह उनको बता सकते हैं कि देखो बच्चों 1913 में ऐसा था, फिर 1923 में ऐसा था, फिर 1930 में साउंड आया, फिर 40 में ये हुआ, 50 में कैसे हमको इंडिपेंडेंस मिला. तो इस तरह की फिल्में बन रही थी. 60 में कलर आया, 70 में अमिताभ बच्चन आए, 80s में आमिर खान आए, एट्सेट्रा एट्सेट्रा एट्सेट्रा. मैं बहुत खुश हूँ क्योंकि पेंगुइन मेरे साथ है पब्लिशर्स, और उन्होंने जिस तरह से इस बुक को पैकेज किया है, पुराने फिल्म के पोस्टर्स के इलस्ट्रेशंस हैं और इसमें फिल्म के पुराने डायलॉग्स हैं. कितना डायलॉग बदल गया है, तो मैं खुश हूँ. शुक्रिया. दो और किताब शायद इसी साल आएगी और दोनों सिनेमा पर नहीं है. एक है भगवान कृष्ण पर और दूसरी है गर्भ संस्कार पर. शुक्रिया.